In this example, we're going to look at the case where we have diffusion and a catalytic reaction. We have a porous non-catalytic layer on top of a flat catalyst surface, and the reaction is A goes to 2B in the gas phase. And the reaction is extremely fast, essentially instantaneous on the catalyst surface. The product B that forms then diffuses back through the porous layer and into the bulk. And in the bulk, diffusion is fast. So the questions we want to answer is, what's the concentration profile for the reactant A in this porous layer? And then what is the flux of A into the layer? So the first thing we want to do is look at a diagram that represents the system. So we have this porous layer where a reactant A is diffusing through this non-catalytic layer and react on the catalyst surface, and then our product B diffuses back out into the bulk. We want to calculate what is this concentration profile in the porous layer, and to do this we need to account for the fact that there's a mole change in this gas phase reaction, which causes a bulk flow in this porous layer. So first thing we want to do is indicate our notation for flux. So this is the molar flux of A. Now the molar flux is consisted in this case of two parts. We have one part due to diffusion, and the other part due to the fact we have bulk flow, and we have this bulk flow because of the mole change. So the diffusion term for component A is a diffusivity and a change in the concentration of A respect to Z. And the minus sign is here because the diffusion is from high concentration to low concentration. And this is just Fick's law. And we can write this in terms of a total concentration times a mole fraction. Just makes it a little easier to do in manipulations. The total concentration from the ideal gas law would just be the pressure over RT. Pressure and temperature are constant in this system, so this total concentration is constant. We're also going to assume that diffusivity is a constant independent of concentration. So now we want to determine the bulk flow. So if we know the molar flux of A plus the molar flux of B, and they're going to have opposite signs, that's the total molar flux. And then I take the mole fraction times that, it would give me what's the bulk flow of component A. WB is just minus 2 times WA from the stoichiometry. And we can substitute this into here, and we can get the bulk flow of A as the mole fraction times minus Y of A. Now we determined up here that the total flux of A is this diffusion term plus the bulk flow term. So we're going to substitute the two terms in that we determined here and here into the flux of A. So we end up with this equation, and now all we're going to do is rearrange. So now we have the flux of A in terms of mole fraction of A, total concentration, diffusivity, and distance. And we now need to take advantage of a mass balance. So we want to take advantage of a mass balance to further determine how does the concentration change with Z, or how does WA change with Z. So again, we'll look at our system and look in particular at Z and at Z plus delta Z and the flux then across these boundaries. In other words, we have the flux in at Z minus the flux out at Z plus delta Z. That's equal to zero. Now keep in mind, flux has sign. And so remember that A is actually moving in this direction. But this equation is a steady state equation that if we divide by delta Z, take the limit, which just says the flux is a constant since there's no reaction in the porous layer. The boundary conditions for this system is that at Z equals zero, The concentration of A is essentially zero because the reaction's instantaneous. And at Z equals delta, the concentration is just Ca at delta, a number that we have to know to obtain this profile. So we can use this equation and apply it to the equation we derived here. And so we're going to make that substitution. So I've made the substitution. I multiply both sides by minus 1 to eliminate the minus sign. So we can take this equation and integrate it, which says that the term inside the derivative is a constant. And we'll eventually need to find the value of this constant. And then we can separate variables, where we have the mole fraction on one side, and we have constants and dz on the other side. Now we can integrate this integral of dy of a 501 plus y of a is the log of 1 plus y of a. A1, c, and d are constants, z, and then we have a constant of integration. So we have these boundary conditions. So when z equals 0, ca equals 0, which means ya equals 0. And can make this substitution into the equation, the log of 1 equals k2, and the log of 1 is 0, so therefore k2 is 0. So I've written the equation now with k2 is 0, and now I can use the other boundary condition, namely at z equals delta, ca is ca delta, or ya is Ca delta over the total concentration. Can make that substitution into the equation. And this means we now have solved for K1. So I can substitute K1 into this equation and obtain an equation that relates the concentration to Z, which is our objective. I'm going to rewrite this. The reason I did that, because now I can take exponential of both sides. And now I can take and just rearrange this equation and solve for the concentration of A in terms of Z and constant. And this was our original objective, is to determine the concentration as a function of Z. The second part of the problem is then to determine the flux of A. So I've just reproduced here an equation that we developed earlier. And now I can substitute in, but first can simplify this by writing this as d of the log of 1 plus yA respect to z. And I'm doing that because here I have the log of 1 plus yA, so I can substitute in this term on the right of that equation. So most of these are constants, and I have dz, dz essentially, which is 1. So that means the flux of A minus cd over delta times the log 1 plus, I'm going to write this in terms of yA again. So this is the flux of A to the surface, so this is the reaction rate because this is a steady state system. The net flux to surface is the amount that reacts.